Sonic the Hedgehog was created by Sega back in 1991 as the new face of their company. Back then, Sega's mascot was Alex Kidd, and the company didn't think he was a strong enough character to give Nintendo's flagship character Mario a run for his money. So Sega went on to develop the Blue Hedgehog, alongside Dr. Ivo Eggman Robotnik, who became his arch nemesis. So you can imagine that the other characters in Sonic's history have an interesting background as well, which is why we've created a list of the top 10 Sonic characters before and after. Let's jump in. At number 10, we have Big the Cat. Love him or hate him, Big the Cat does have an interesting backstory when it comes to his creation. Sort of. If you despise the character, like so many Sonic fans do, well, this may lead you to liking him even less, if possible. So Big the Cat, who first appeared in Sonic Adventure DX, was solely the product of developers wanting to create a fishing minigame to give purpose to the fishing rod item. Thus begun Big the Cat's journey to reacquire Froggy, which many critics see as one of the strangest gameplay modes in the game. Since then, the character's personality hasn't changed much, but he has taken a much smaller spot in the limelight as a playable character in games like Sonic Heroes and Sonic and Sega All-Stars Racing. In at number 9 is Egg Robo. While Egg Robo may not be the first antagonist to come to mind when you think of Sonic characters, the various Egg Robo appearances over the years have been diverse and interesting, constantly providing a challenge for players. First appearing in Sonic & Knuckles in 1994, the Egg Robo has been a staple in the Sonic franchise, even appearing in the likes of the Sonic Mania Mirage Saloon Zone recently, as a bit of a character duplicating magician known as the Heavy Magician. Egg Robo has become a versatile villain for Sonic to fight, with multiple variants over time. Up next, number 8 is Fang the Sniper. Fang the Sniper may not be one of the more well-known Sonic characters, but he definitely has changed quite a bit aesthetically from his early days in Sonic Triple Trouble, or otherwise known in Japan as Sonic and Tails 2, as an antagonist who is after the Chaos Emeralds. In the game pre-release marketing, Fang was featured holding a gun, pointing it directly at Sonic, which never actually appeared in the game itself. From then on, he's been a minor playable character in games the likes of Sonic Drift 2 and Sonic the Fighters. And he also appears in Sonic Mania, but not as himself. In the battle we mentioned in our last number with the Heavy Magician, he appears as an illusion for Sonic to battle. But aside from that, the character has been pretty MIA, partially due to what critics called lazy characterization when he first appeared in Sonic Triple Trouble. Up next, number 7 is Metal Sonic. First appearing in the 1993 Sonic CD, Metal Sonic was created with the intention of fleshing out more of Sonic's world. Kazuyuki Hoshino was tasked with creating two new characters, one of which was Amy Rose, and the second, Metal Sonic. Hoshino was privy to the Sega Technical Institute's desire to introduce a mechanical version of Sonic, so he took the helm and began crafting the character as an antagonist rather than an ally, which complemented the idea of Eggman wanting to create a robot adequate of taking out his nemesis. From then on out, he's been a fan favorite, and has also seen many variations over the years as he became more and more obsessed with becoming the better version of Sonic. Up next, number 6 is Knuckles. With the success of Sonic the Hedgehog 2 and Sonic CD, it was only a brief matter of time before Sonic the Hedgehog 3 was put into development. Sega had an affinity for holding character creation competitions at its technical institute, and there was one held that Takashi Yuda won with his design of a spiny green echidna. This would later evolve into Knuckles, changing his color to red in an attempt to make him more of a standout compared to Sonic's blue and Tails' yellow. Speaking of, up next, number 5 is Tails. Tails was introduced in the follow-up to the hit success of the first game in Sonic the Hedgehog 2 in 1992. Sega specifically wanted a character that would be a companion to Sonic, his archetypical sidekick, who would be playable in hopes to draw in new players to the game. After running a competition at Sega Technical Institute for designs, Yasushi Yamaguchi's two-tailed orange fox was chosen, who he named Miles Prower, as a reference to Sonic's speed, since it sounded like miles per hour. Ultimately, his name was changed to Tails for simplicity's sake, but rather than ditching the first name, Tails became his nickname, Miles Tails Prower. And at number 4 is Vector the Crocodile. Vector's first appearance was in 1995 in the Chaotix game, but he was developed years prior to that, back in 1990. During the conceptual stages of the 1991 Sonic the Hedgehog game, developers at Team Sonic began crafting the world around Sonic and Dr. Eggman, the two characters they had created at the time. One of the concepts was that Sonic would be part of a band called Sonic the Hedgehog Band, and featured Vector. Ultimately, the idea was abandoned, but Vector would return a few years later, still wearing his iconic headphones. And at number 3 is Amy Rose. After the success of the first two Sonic games, the development for Sonic CD had developers wanting to introduce more characters to the canon. This included our previous number, Metal Sonic, but also a female companion for Sonic. Amy Rose was inspired from the female character's companion that appeared in the Sonic the Hedgehog manga, with a new and improved design that ditched her mohawk-styled hair and and gave her a new outfit. The character was largely unused in her early days despite being a damsel in distress, but since then has become one of the more important Sonic characters in Sonic's main circle, capable of holding her own with the addition of her Pico Pico hammer. Up next, number 2 is Robotnik. As we mentioned in the start of this video, Sega was looking to replace its mascot Alex Kidd with a character capable of rivaling Mario and Nintendo. Two characters were drafted up, one being Sonic and the other Dr. Ivo Eggman Robotnik. While Sonic was ultimately voted as the winner, Sega didn't want to get rid of the Eggman design, thinking it still had a lot of potential. The character was noted to share similarities with the US President Theodore Roosevelt, except was wearing pajamas, and was later redesigned further, having more of a bee-like persona in terms of his attacks. This would change yet again, simplifying him, ditching the PJs and giving him a red, black, and yellow color scheme in order to differentiate him from Sonic. Since then, Robotnik has received many a transformation, including Sonic's 06 hyper-realistic version of the character, but regardless has retained most of his iconic features since his debut in the 1991 Sonic the Hedgehog game. And last but not least, number 1 is Sonic. Since Sonic's debut, the character has enjoyed 5 generations of console releases, as of this recording. In 1990, an internal competition was held for the creation of Sega's mascot, as we've mentioned in our previous numbers, and led to the design that ranged from a Felix the Cat-inspired rabbit to an American-looking bulldog, but nothing quite struck a note as well as the design for the Blue Hedgehog, who at the time was named Mr. Needlemouse, and was aesthetically inspired by the likes of Michael Jackson and Santa Claus, and a personality inspired by future President Bill Clinton. After the 1991 game's release, Sonic had spawned a trend for anthropomorphic mascots, opening the door for the likes of Crash Bandicoot, Spyro, and Sly Cooper, amongst others. While the character, like Eggman, has always retained his iconic traits, he's received many slight aesthetic makeovers over the years, from the way he's perceived in 3D Sonic games, to his characterization in the various Sonic animated series, like Sonic the Hedgehog and Sonic Boom. Alright, there we have it, friends. Want us to do another before and after list? Let us know in this comments below. And if you dug this video, please show some love by hitting those like and subscribe buttons. And hey, share it with a friend! We've also got a ton of other Sonic lists on our Top 10 Sonic playlist, so head on over to our channel and check that out. In the meantime, I've been Kelly Pally and this has been Top 10 Gaming. I'll catch you all in the next one.